Hi guys, my name is Andrew. So we'll be doing a problem from page 214, number 14C. So it reads as follows. Human error has been given as the primary cause of error in 70% of the accidents in industry. So number C says, for a random sample of 500 industrial accidents, estimate the probability that. Yeah, so as we all can see, this is a binomial because it's either accidents are caused by human error or they are not caused by the human error. So it's X binomial where our N is 500, then the pi is 0.7. So if we check from our binomial distribution table, the N ends at 32, but here our N is 500. That means we should convert it now to normal distribution. So there are two rules before converting. So the first one is to find pi. Sorry.
Is it what? N times pi.
Which is 500 times 0.7. And it gives us 350. This is the mean, which is greater than 5. So now we're looking for the variance, which is n pi into 1 minus pi, which is 350 into 1 minus 0.7, which gives us 105, which is also greater than 5. So if this, the mean and the variance are both greater than 5, we can convert it to the normal distribution. So we're gonna have y normal, then our mean is 350. Then our variance is 105 now.
In terms of that second thing, the n pi into 1 minus pi, isn't it supposed to be n 1 minus pi?
No, it's n pi 1 minus, because we want the variance, it's the variance. And the variance is n pi 1 minus. Oh yeah, I saw the same error in the module. It's an error. It's an error. It's an error. It's an error.
Well, when you're checking the conditions, you're only checking whether the n times the possibility of success is greater than 5 and whether the n times the possibility of failure is greater than 5. The one you did below is the variance. It's correct for the variance, but you need to check for the possibility of failure as well.
So I was wrong. So it should be
n times 1 minus pi. Yeah.
That's 500. Minus 0.7, which gives us 1/5, right? Which is also greater than 5. So then now we can convert it to normal approximation.
So now we can remove that one. Greater than 5 here, because that's for variance.
Oh yeah. This doesn't have to be there. So the first question says, estimate the probability that more than 450 are primarily caused by human error. Probability of X being greater than 450. Right? So this is the same as the probability that X is greater or equal to 451. Which is approximately probability of Y being greater or equal to. So under like normal distribution thing for continuity, it's either we add 0.5 or we subtract 0.5. So if they want the probability of something being greater than or greater or equal to a certain number, so we should subtract 0.5. If it's less or equal to, we should add 0.5. So in this case, we should subtract 0.5. That means it's gonna be 450.5. Right? So then that's the probability of Z being greater or equal to. So to convert from Y to Z, the formula is Z equals to the X that you are given. That means you're going to have the Y minus the mean. Yeah, minus the mean that we found here. Minus the mean, something like that, divided by the standard deviation. So for this one, our x is 450.5. Then we have to subtract the mean of 350. Then we divide by the standard deviation, right? But here we've got the variance, it's not the standard deviation. So it should be the square root so that it can be the standard deviation now. So this is the probability of Z being greater or equal to, we put that on the calculator. Then we get 9.8078. So our table doesn't have 4 units after the comma, it only have 2, so we have to round it off to 2 decimal places now, which is the probability of Z being greater or equal to 9.81. So from our table, Z distribution, table 1, it only gives us the values where like Z is less, not great. It should be less or equal to, not great. So what we have to do now is to take this from greater or equal to 9.81 to less. So it's like this now. It's a normal distribution. So let's say we have 9.81 here. So the probability that they want here, they want this part, where it's greater or equal to.
Question. How is it equal to 9.8?
How is it equal to 9.8?
Yeah.
It's this one, this whole thing. When we put it in the calculator, it gives us 9.81.
Because there's no 9.81 on the table.
Yeah, I will come to that point. We're still busy. Yeah. So, as you can see, the table gives us the values to the left, not to the right. And here we want the value to the right. So the best way is to take this whole thing now, which is 1. Then we subtract the values to the left to get that portion now. So it's going to be 1 minus the probability of Z being less than or equal to 9.81, right? Which is 1 minus. So we should look for this in the table. That one you were talking about, that it's not in the table, right?
Mm.
But if you check the table, the last value there is 4, right?
Yeah.
And if you check all the values at 4, like it's 0.9997, 0.999, 0.999, that means as the number keeps going up there from 4 to 9 to 8, yeah, like it gets closer to 1.
Yeah.
So obviously, like if at 4 it's 0.9997, so this one obviously is gonna be 1. So the probability, that means it's gonna be 0. Approximately 0. Understand?
Can you please explain?
Like, if you check table 1, right?
Yeah.
Table 1. Check 0. Okay, let's just start. 2.0 there. You see 2.0? Just check 2.0 on the table. Or any number. Check the values there.
Yeah.
You see? Then compare them with the values from 4.0. Like you see that this number, it keeps increasing now. Mm-hmm. They're getting closer and closer to 1.
Yeah.
So obviously, like if we keep going down here from 4, 5, 6, 7, 8,
mm-hmm.
we're getting to 1. That means
okay.
The probability there is 1.
Oh.
It will no longer be 0.99.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
So the second part of the question says, estimate the probability between 400 and 450. Okay. So now I can erase this from here. So now we want the probability of X, where it's greater than 400. And which is less than 450. So we're gonna do the same thing that we did now. We just take it from X to Y and calculate. From Y to Z, then calculate the probability. So this will be equal to, so as I said, if it's greater or equal to, we subtract 0.5. That's here. That means we should subtract 0.5 from 400. If it's less or equal to, we should add 0.5. So we're gonna subtract 0.5 here at 0.5 here. The probability of, it's what, 399.5?
Yeah.
Which is less or equal to, why? Less or equal to 450.9. So what we have to do now, we have to take it now to Z distribution because, yeah, no because actually. So it's the probability of we do the same thing that we did there. So we got 399.5 minus 350 divided by the square root of 105, which is less or equal to Z now. So we got 450.5 minus 350 divided by square root of 105. So what will be the values?
4.8377
less or equal to Z, less or equal to 0.7.
Yeah.
0.7. And this one is, isn't it the same as the last one? The one that we did before? It is.
9.8 1.
It was 80.77.
Yeah.
So we take it to two decimal places. So here we want the probability that Z is between these two values, right? Then we can draw it on a table and have something like this, 9.81, then 4.83. So we want this one now. So what we can do, we can look for probability that Z is less than 9.81. That means it's from here going there. Then we have to subtract the probability that X less than that portion. You get it?
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I don't think it's supposed to be less or equal to. So it should be only less than, not equal signs. After converting it to normal, no equal signs, it's just less than. So we're going to have the probability of Z being less than 9.81 minus the probability of Z being less than 4.81.
Right. So do we remove the less than or equal sign when it's turned to normal or when we add and subtract the 0.5?
When we add and subtract 0.5, yeah. We remove the equal signs. So we only need less than.
Yeah.
It's 4.81 on 8.3. 4.83, sorry, not 8.1.
Okay, your 9.81 is correct.
4.8.
So we found out that the probability of this is 1, right? So now we have to find the probability of less than 4.83. And still, the last number is 4. So it's gonna be 1 again, because this is greater than 4. So which will be approximately 0 once again. Thank you.
Question though.
Question.
Would it be wrong? You see how 4 ends off at 0.99998, And then I just say that the 8.3 could be a 9.9 somewhere there. Would I be wrong in doing that?
No, I don't think it's, you're not wrong.
Okay.
As long as it has many 9s in it. Yeah, that's it.